On today's episode, supersonic commercial aviation may go boom. Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. Commercial air travel at supersonic speeds was once thought to be the next big step in air travel. Just as the turbojet engine made nonstop transcontinental and transoceanic flight possible, Mach 2 speeds promised breakfast in New York and lunch in Paris or London. Now, the race to make such an airplane, it boiled down to the Russian Tupolev Design Bureau, a partnership between France's Aerospatiale and the British Aircraft Corporation, and the large American airframe manufacturers, notably Boeing. Now, the American companies calculated that the enterprise risk and uncertain economics of the venture made it unwise, and they looked to government to backstop the program, to no avail. But the Russians and the French-British partnership pressed on, and in the mid-1970s, Concorde became the fastest way to get across the Atlantic. But those poor economics, combined with an unfortunate accident and environmental concerns, meant that Concorde operations stopped in 2003, with only 14 aircraft ever used commercially. The Tupolev Tu-144 was even less successful, carrying passengers for less than a year. While a brilliant technical success, Concorde was hampered by a number of factors, from high fuel burn and operating costs to flight restrictions due to concerns about sonic boom. It was a technological masterpiece, but technology's advanced considerably in the 50 years since Concorde took flight. Denver-based Boom Supersonic has created a small airliner capable of Mach 1.7 speeds that the firm plans to fly by 2026. The 200-foot-long aircraft will carry 65 to 80 passengers with a range of over 4,000 nautical miles at a 60,000-foot cruising altitude. The tailed delta design is optimized with a very complex compound curvature fuselage and gull wings with four potted turbojet engines similar to the Convair B-58. The complex shape offers reduced supersonic drag with good low-speed controllability, and significantly, the aircraft can supercruise, meaning it can fly supersonically without the need for afterburners. Now, Concorde could also supercruise, although it used afterburners for takeoff and acceleration. Supersonic flight without afterburners greatly reduces fuel burn and simplifies maintenance, and the engines will be capable of burning carbon-neutral green aviation fuel. The aircraft will be built in a 400,000-square-foot production facility in North Carolina, with design and development work centered in Denver. Technical partners include Northrop Grumman, Collins Aerospace, Eaton, Rolls-Royce, Safran, and the U.S. Air Force. So the technical challenges are well in hand, but the critical make-or-break in airliner development has never been aerodynamics or power plants, but economics. Boeing's 2707 supersonic airliner project was stillborn because of high development costs and uncertain profitability, and Concorde was never a viable moneymaker for airlines, although it had value as a prestige halo service for Air France and British Airways. So how will Boom Supersonic's Overture be different? Advanced structures in avionics, manufacturing advantages from composites and advanced light alloys, and critically, simplified engines compared to Concorde without afterburners or complex active inlet systems will help. Airlines have shown interest, and significantly, American Airlines has placed a non-refundable deposit on 20 aircraft with an option to purchase an additional 40. So will Boom Supersonic succeed where some of the world's biggest airframers have failed? Well, one of the advantages of modern engineering development tools such as model-based design, computational fluid dynamics, and advanced simulation is that they allow smaller firms to replace complex and expensive physical testing with high-reliability virtual models. And those models can be validated to give customers like American Airlines confidence that they can order off the drawing board and get airliners that meet performance specifications. And as a result, by 2029, the world may have commercial flight at twice the speed of current airliners. Well, that's it for today's episode of This Week in Engineering, brought to you by engineering.com. For our deeper engineering series, visit engineering.com TV for exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future and Designing the Future, not found on our YouTube channel. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching.